स्टिल पीपल आ जाए, स्टिल सम पीपल आर जॉइनिंग। जगदीश रेड्डी एच नॉट, एच नॉट। या what is the last topic, Shirisha? Can you tell what is the last topic we have been discussing? And the pointers are we started structures in pointers only. What is the last topic in pointers we have been discussing? Let me know in the message, Shirisha, or the next year. Pointers to array, pointer to array. Okay, I got the reply. Thank you. Pointer to array, we have been discussing. Yeah. Yes. Yeah. This call by value and call by reference is over, and pointer to pointer is over, pointer arithmetic is also over. We have discussed the scaling factor. If we increment the integer pointer, then it will be incremented by 2 bytes. P plus 1 means it will move to the 3rd byte. So integer point, because it is an integer pointer, and if we are incrementing or decrementing a floating point pointer, then it will be jump by a hop of 4 bytes size. If it is a character pointer, then your incrementation will be the next location, that is only 1 byte. So pointer to an array we have been discussing, right? Pointer to an array. So basically here we want to store the base address of the array in a pointer. So what is the base address of this array? A, it is 2000, for example. So the value is 1, and the location address, the first location, 0th location address is 2000. So since it is an integer type, will take 2 bytes, we are assuming, then the next address will be 2002, and the next address will be 2004, 6, 8, like that. So the elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 present in the array A. So then by using an array, I can point to this first location. I can save the first location address in the pointer P by assigning like this. So I declared an array of 5 size, A of 5 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So then this is the memory configuration. After that, integer pointer P, I have declared, and I'm assigning the first address, the base address of this array A, to this integer pointer P. Ankit Raj, 4C7, Ankit Raj, why you are late? Come in time, otherwise I need to disturb the class, and again I need to move to this place to admit you. Okay, so I have declared an array, and still 2 people. E7, Sindhu. E7. Yeah, I have declared an array of 5 size, and I have assigned some values, elements to this array, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So after that, I declared an integer pointer P, and I'm assigning P equal to A. Integer pointer P equal to A means, why I'm not using address operator here? Because as we know that the array name itself will point to the base address of the array. The array name itself contains the base address of the array, so that I can directly give the base address assignment like this. I'm assigning pointer P equal to A means the base address of this array A is going to be stored in the pointer P. So that is 2000 is stored in pointer P, and now a connection is established to this. The pointer will point to the first location of this array, the 0th location, the element is 1, and the address is 2000. So after that, I'm taking I as an integer variable. So that is a printing array elements. I'm printing by using this for loop for I equal 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. Each time I'm printing star of P. As you know, that star of P means the value that is available in the location that is pointed by the pointer p. So pointer p is pointing to this location. After that, I will increment p plus plus so that now the pointer will point to the second time or the second iteration, the pointer will point to the next location. So then I will print the star p. That means 2 is going to be printed. Like that, 3, 4, 5, all these elements are going to be printed. So this is the way I can print by using a pointer to an array. RAM streaker. So that is one program. Another one is I want to find out the sum of the array elements using array pointer. It's a very, very important question. So sum of the array I want to compute by using a pointer array or a pointer to an array. So here I'm taking an integer array of size 5. That is, these values are assigned to the array. And after that, I've taken two variables, I for loop repetition and sum for finding the sum of all these elements, adding all these elements and storing in this sum variable. So initially the sum value is 0, we initialize, and we have taken an integer pointer star ptr, ptr equal to a, that is assigning the address of a, base address of a to the pointer. So that can be like this also, a of 0, address of a of 0 is the base address, or else you can directly give address of a, that is also base address, or you can directly give pointer equal to a, that is also base address. Three ways we can assign the base address of an array to a pointer variable. After that, I am taking another for loop for I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus. So each time I am adding sum to the pointer value. What is the pointer value? The pointer which is pointing to the location, that value is going to be taken. Initially, the pointer is pointing to the first location. The first location that consists of the value 1. 1 is going to be added to the initial sum, 0 plus 1, 1. So after that, pointer is incremented so that the pointer now points to the second location, that is 2 element, where the 2 element is present. So now the sum is 1 plus 2, it is 3. 3 is going to be stored in the sum. So like that, pointer is incremented each time and the previous sum is going to be summed up with the current element. Like that, all the elements are going to be added to the sum. So now, at last, after I becomes 5, this condition becomes false. We will come out of the loop and we will print the sum. The sum is 15. So that Likit E4. Likit, why you are late? Why you are so late? Okay, this is about a pointer pointer to an array for finding the sum of the array elements. After that, another topic is a pointer to void. It is that means we can create a generic pointer by not mentioning the data type of the pointer. We can mention, we have to mention it as a void. So void point, void star, that pointer name, void star some pointer name. That means it is a generic pointer. It is not going to hold any type of data value. So we are defining it as a generic pointer by mentioning it as a void, so that in future we can assign an integer address, integer variable address, or floating point variable address, or else a character variable address. We can assign any type of variable address to this generic pointer in the forthcoming lines of the code or in the future. So this way I can define a generic pointer like this void star pointer name, so that it can be used for storing any type of variable address. So for example, you can see here void star a, I'm declaring, that means the pointer a is a void pointer, a generic pointer. That means it is, since we are not mentioning any data type, it can hold any type of data type, so that you can in future you can use it for holding any type of any data type address. After that, I am declaring integer n equal to 2 star m. N is an integer variable and star m is an integer point. And I am declaring double d equal to 2.3 and star c. That means floating point variable is declared. And Sheikh Maksud, why you are late? Floating point variable is declared and the star and a pointer c for floating point value address storing purpose we are declared. So after that, here in this line, this is very, very important. In this line, I'm assigning the address of n to this pointer a. So the address of n I'm assigning to this pointer a. That means as we have declared the pointer A as a void pointer, that is a generic pointer. Here, by this line, I am assigning the integer variable n. Integer variable n is declared here, n equal to 2, integer n equal to 2. So integer variable n's address is going to be stored in this pointer A. That means now the pointer A will act as an integer pointer. Now the pointer A is acting as an integer pointer. So like that, we can store in future after some time. Again, here you can see, again A is assigned with the address of D. Here up to this line, the pointer A is a void pointer, generic pointer. After that, whenever you are executing this line, now the pointer A is an integer pointer. After that, after some time, again we are assigning A equal to address of D, that means double. So here now the A pointer is holding the address of a double variable. Now the A pointer will act as a double pointer, that is it can hold the address of a double variable. So like that, you can modify the capability of holding a different data type addresses, data type variable addresses, by mentioning it as a void pointer. So after that, you are giving m equal to a. That means whatever the Maksud, you should not chat to your friends. Listen to the class, otherwise I will disconnect you. You came for the class, you listen the class. No, don't chat, don't do any messaging. Otherwise, I will put your attendance as absent. G2H2. G2H2, why you are so late? క్లాస్ టైంకి జాయిన్ కావాలమ్మా, నేను లింక్ పంపించిన వెంటనే 5 మినిట్స్ లోపే జాయిన్ కావాలి, అదర్వైజ్ యువర్ అటెండెన్స్ విల్ నాట్ బి మార్క్. నేను ప్రతిసారి ఇట్లా క్లాస్ డిస్టర్బ్ చేసి మిమ్మల్ని అడ్మిట్ చేసుకుంటా కూర్చోలేను. ఓకే, సో సీ హియర్ ఐఎమ్ అసైనింగ్ ద ఏ టు ఎమ్, దట్ మీన్స్ అగైన్ ద అడ్రస్ ఆఫ్ ఏ, దట్ ఈస్ ద అడ్రస్ ఆఫ్ ఏ ఇస్ గోయింగ్ టు బి అసైన్ టు ద పాయింటర్ వేరియబుల్ ఎమ్. సో లైక్ దట్ ఈస్ we are assigning some address. The address is going to be copied into another integer pointer. So like that, I am printing the A and the star M, that is what is the value that is there in that pointer, and what is the address, what is the pointer value, what is the value that is there in the location that is pointed by M, and here what is the value that is there in the pointer. So like that, after that I am assigning the A as the address of the double variable, so that now A will become a pointer to double variable. So again, C equal to A, that is again double, the A is assigned with the double pointer. So recovering, this is called recovering. So like that, we can modify the whole theme of this. Is we can declare a void pointer so that in future we any type of address, either it may be a integer, it may be float, or it may be character variable, those addresses can be stored in this void pointer according to your requirement. So that is the purpose of a generic pointer, or a pointer to void, or a void pointer. Okay, so this is what about a generic pointer, a void pointer. So as you know that there are no, these all arithmetic operators like star and that is multiplication, division and modulo, all these are illegal for your pointer. Only arithmetic addition, subtraction, increment, decrement, pre-increment, pre-decrement, post-increment, post-decrement, these are all only the operations, arithmetic operations that are allowed on the pointers. So remaining all are not allowed. Those are illegal operations. So after that, you can see one more topic, that is array of pointers. That means, so earlier we have seen that a pointer to an array, that means a single pointer is there that is pointing to the base address of the array, that means the first location of the array. This is pointer to an array. So whereas the next topic is array of pointers, that means we are going to declare a number of sequential pointers, a number of pointers by using the array indexing, array method, array declaration method, same as your array variable declaration. You just define in an array of pointers like this. integer star p of 5. That means there are 5 number of pointers are there, integer pointers. So that can hold 5 number of addresses of integer type variables. So that's what the meaning, array of pointers. Here, number of pointers are there in this pointer array. So that, for example, you can see here in this program, we have declared an array A of 5 size and have assigned some values like 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 like this. So array A is there. After that, I'm declaring an array of pointers like this, integer star P of 5. That means P1, P0, P1, P2, P3 like that. So 5 pointers are declared here as an array. So after that, I want to store the address of each element, 0th element address in this P. So that I'm assigning address of A of 0 to P. That is whatever, wherever that 10 is located, that location address is going to be copied into P. After that, P plus 1. So P plus 1 will consist of, I'm assigning the address of A of 1 like this. P plus 2, A of 2 address. P plus 3 holds A of 3 address. P plus 4 holds A of 4 address. Why we are using P plus 1? Because whatever the integer type is there, that many number of bytes are going to be added to this so that the next address we will get. Suppose here the P address is 2000, then P plus 1 will be 2002 as our system takes 2 bytes of memory for integer type. Then P plus 2 will be 2004. Then P plus 3 will be 2006 like that. That means 2 into our 2 bytes of memory for your integer type. 3 into 2 bytes of memory for integer type like that. P plus 4 means 2008. So like that, the memory locations will be there and that will store the addresses of A0, A1, A2, A3, A4 and A3, A4. After that, I'm printing those addresses. I'm printing the addresses by using this U, %U. I'm printing P, P plus 1, P plus 2, P plus 3, P plus 4. That means all the array pointers, array of pointers, I'm printing individually by using this. Okay, that means 2000, 2002, 2004, 2006, 2008, all these values are going to be printed by using, if the address of this first location is 2000. So then increment by 2, all addresses will be incremented by 2 because it is an integer type array. So that addresses are going to be printed here. So that is one program. And to demonstrate that same thing, array of pointers, I am taking another program for printing the sum of array elements by using array of pointers. Array of pointers. So here you can see an array is declared A of 5 equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And we are taking two variables, integer I and sum equal to 0. Sum is for finding the sum of all the elements in the array. And star I is for loop repetition purpose. Integer star PTR of 5, I am declaring an array of pointers of 5 pointers. So here in this loop, I am doing the address assignment. So for I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus space. So each time I'm assigning the address of A of I to pointer of I. So I'm assigning all the addresses, the first element, 0th element, one element, second element, third element, fourth element, fourth position element, all the addresses where this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 resides. Those location addresses that I'm copying into pointer of 0, pointer of 1, pointer of 2 like that. Correspondingly, those addresses are going to be copied. So after that, in the next for loop, I'm actually finding the sum. For I equal to 0, I less than 5, I plus plus, I'm assigning star PTR of 5. That is PTR of 0 for the first time. PTR of 0 is pointing to the location where that one resides. So star indirection operator I'm applying means that location, the value that is there in that location I need to take. Star PTR is, that's the meaning. So first time it will take the one value and it is going to be sum added to the sum. Initial value is 0 and 1. Pointer of 0 is 1. That 1 is going to be added to 0 and it is going to be updated to the sum variable 1. Next time I is incremented so that I will get the 1. I now becomes 1. Now the pointer of 1 value is 2. Star PTR of 1 value is 2. The 2 is going to be added to the previous sum. What is the previous sum? 0 plus 1, it was 1. So 1 plus 2, it will give 3. 3 is going to be updated to the sum. And now sum contains the 3 value. So like that, I is incremented again. Now the pointer will point to the, I now becomes 2. The pointer will point to this third element 3, right? So that value is picked up and it is going to be added to the previous sum. Previous sum is 3. Previous sum is 3. So 3 is going to be added to the 3. 3 is going to be added to 3. Now it is 6. 6 is going to be updated to the sum variable. So like that, all the elements are going to be added to this previous sum. So at final, I will get the sum as 15. So after I becomes 5, this condition becomes false, then we will come out of the loop and we are printing the array sum is percentage D sum, that is sum of all the elements in the array 15. It is going to be printed. So this way I can find the sum of array elements by using an array of pointers. So after that, you can see here one more small program for demonstrating the array of pointers. I'm taking this character array of pointers like this, point the char star name equal to MREC is one word, RE Hyderabad is one word, and India is another word. So three words are going to be stored in three different locations like this. Three words are going to be stored in one line. In one memory location, this MREC is going to be stored, and the base address is going to be given to this name of zero. In the name of zero, the base address of this MREC is going to be stored. And after that, in Hyderabad is going to be stored in another location, and the address is going to be stored in name of one. So like that, India is going to be stored in another location, and the base address of this is going to be stored in name of 2, 0, 1, 2. Three pointers will be there: star, name of zero, name of one, name of two. Name of zero will point to the MREC base address, and name of one will point to the Hyderabad base address, and name of two will point to the India base address, like that. So these arrays are going to, these character arrays are going to be pointed by these three pointers. Now I'm taking a loop variable I, and I'm repeating from 0 to 2. Each time I'm printing the string by taking the pointer, that is name of I. Name of I is, initially it is 0, that will point to MREC, that will be printed as a string. And I is incremented, I now becomes 1, then name of 1, that name of 1 pointer is pointing to the Hyderabad string, that string is going to be printed. So and again, now I is incremented, I now becomes 2, then this condition true, again I am printing percentage, yes, name of 2. What is name of 2? The name of 2 will point to the India, so that India is going to be printed. After that, I is incremented, I now becomes 3, this condition is false, then we will come out of the loop and get CS. Program ended. So by that time, the output is like this. Three words are going to be pointed by three pointers, and all these words are printed by using this pointer. So this is a way I can use array of pointers for storing the character arrays and the printing those, accessing those character arrays. So this is about this. And after that, I have 6 minutes left. Still people are coming for joining. I don't allow them. Only 6 minutes class is left. So after that, we will move on to I want to discuss a small two programs. Okay. This we have already discussed in the last before class, I think. GCD, finding the GCD, as you know, that N1 and N2 two numbers are given. We want to find out the GCD so that we will find out the factors of these two numbers, and we will take the common factors, and from the common factors also, whichever the greatest two common factor is there, that is our GCD, so that you know how this program is computing. So the same thing, the same GCD program by using recursion, it is given here in this. So I'm declaring a function called HCF, which take integer type variables, two integer type variables, and will return integer value. That is a function prototype. After that, in the main function, I am declaring two variables, N1 and N2. And in this, I'm asking the user to enter two numbers. After that, I'm reading those two numbers into N1 and N2. And here I'm printing GCD of these two numbers is this. I'm calling this function. So whenever I'm calling this function, I'm passing the N1 and N2, and those are going to be copied here. So this is a condition. If N2 is not equal to 0, then return N2 comma N1 modulus N2. So I'm recursively calling the function so that it will go on like this. Suppose, say, for example, my values are 54 and 24. I want to find out. For the first time, when it is called, it is going to be given like this. it is going to come here, and after that I need to pass this, and again I will call the same function recursively. It's f of n2. What is n2? N2 is 24, and n1 modulus n2 is 6. 24 modulus 54 is 6, remainder is 6. Again it will call the same function, because n2 is not equal to 0, 6 is not equal to 0. Again it will call the recursively, then n2 will become now n1, right? N2 will become now n1, and 6 comma, when you divide this n1 modulus n2, n1 is 24, n2 is 6, then 6 was a 24, then it is 6, it is 0, the remainder is 0. Then after that you cannot call again, because n2 is not equal to 0, the condition is false, because it n2 now becomes 0. So then whatever the n1 is there at that point, that will be returned. It will comes to the else part, and that will be returned as a GCD. That is a GCD. So this way you can call, you can find the GCD of given two numbers recursively. So this is a program, no problem. I will send this. I will send this notes to you. Another concept is, another program is Armstrong number. As you know that the cube, sum of the cubes of individual digits is the Armstrong number. If it is equal to the same number, sum of the cubes of individual digits is equal to the same number, then it is called as Armstrong number. So for this, the program is like this. Integer num, the number you are going to read, and the original num for duplicating the duplicate copy of the same number is going to be stored here in this. And remainder, REM, and result equal to 0. We are reading a number, and that is read into this num variable. And after that num variable is going to be copied into the original num variable. So now I am using this while loop. While original num is not equal to 0, each time I am getting the reminder. So we need to get the reminder, and we need to find the cube of that reminder. Here I am finding the cube and adding that into the result. So like that, each time I am taking one digit. First time I will take the 3 as a reminder, next time I will take the 5 as a reminder, next time I will take the 1 as a reminder. All the 3 are cubed, and that sum is going to be added to the result. So after that I will apply the division operator to get the next reminder, next quotient, so that it will be continued up to it is now, while it is equal to 0. It is not equal to 0, it will continue. Otherwise if it is 0, then it will break that while loop and it will come over here. If result is equal to num, that is the cube sum is equal to the original number that is given, then it is an Armstrong number. Otherwise it is not an Armstrong number. This way it is going to be executed. So initially it is the num value is 153. The original num is also 153. We are copied here. So after that we are applying this module operator, so that you will get that remainder as 3 first time. So 3 is cubed, and it is going to be added to that result. Initially it was 0. 3 cubed, it is 27. So the session will close in 1 minute. So 27 will be added to the result. After that, again, original num is divided by 10, so that we will get the quotient as 15. Now again, we will modulo this 15 to get the remainder as 5, right? 5. Again, 5 is cubed, so that you will get the 152. Now 152 plus 27, the value is going to be stored that 5 cube is going to be computed. And that 5 cube is added to the 27, so that you will get 152, and that is stored in the result. Again we will go to the quotient, that is a division operator, and we will get 1. And 1 again, you will go for finding the remainder. The remainder is 1. You will get that 1 cube is 1, that is going to be added to this 152, and 153 you will get. By that time